Welcome everyone to the last episode from Transylvanian foods. In today's video, it has to be a special video, so I'm gonna show you how to do a steak in a Transylvanian way. We're gonna have a lot of meat, we're gonna have potato, we're gonna have porcini mushrooms, amazing porcini mushrooms, but we're gonna go through all the ingredients in a minute, and after we're gonna start to cook. Now I would like to remember you that starting from next week, we start a new series of videos with Mediterranean food. So I'm gonna cook a dish from each country around the Mediterranean Sea, and I will ask you if you got any suggestion or if you want me to cook a specific dish from any of the countries from Mediterranean area. Please let me know in the comments and I will do it with pleasure. Now let's go through the ingredients. The ingredients for this recipe are, I got here an amazing sirloin steak. I got 2 slices of the smoked lard, the meaty one. You can see our Transylvanian octopus. I got 2 potatoes. I'm gonna use Mary's Pipers for this recipe, and you need to know that I boiled this potato earlier and I had to leave it to cool down so I can show you the whole process. I got here some lovely porcini mushrooms. I love porcini mushrooms, these are amazing. I got garlic, I got some parsley, we got 4 spring onions, and I got 1 garlic as well. All these are from my garden, what you see here. I got here some double cream or heavy cream and 2 tablespoons of sweet paprika. If you prefer the spicy one, you can use the spicy one. It's totally up to you. You just need to follow the technique steps, except that if you want to swap one of the ingredients, you can do it. Let's do the prep for this dish and after we start to cook. I'm gonna start by seasoning the steak, and for a nice steak you can only use fresh cracked pepper. I got here a mix of pepper. Make sure you press it nicely. I normally use olive oil to put on the steak before I cook it, but in this case, because we do a Transylvanian twist on it, I'm not gonna use any olive oil. So we put the pepper, and now I'm gonna put some rock salt, just a tiny bit, because we're gonna put when we serve more. That's pretty much it for the steak. Now we're gonna start with the vegetables. One thing which I forgot to mention for the steak, you have to take it out the fridge and to keep it at room temperature with minimum 10-15 minutes before you're gonna cook it. Like that the meat will relax and it's gonna be much tender and it's gonna cook nicely, even. Now we're gonna start with the potatoes. I'm just gonna peel them. I use a spoon for this. I know it's not very common, but this is how I learned 20 years ago to peel potatoes. And trust me, I did peel tons. And you don't have too much waste either. Now I'm gonna take a grater. And on this side of the grater, I'm gonna grate the potato. And I do need a bowl for that. So I'm just gonna grate them like this. It's a very simple garnish recipe, but it's full of flavor and very, very tasty. To be honest, I didn't see it anywhere except in Transylvania people to do it. Not even in restaurants or on somebody else's house, except in Transylvania, of course. Okay, and this is pretty much for the potato what we do for now. I got here the spring onion from my garden. I'm very proud of it and looks very nice and it tastes very nice. I'm gonna cut this. I will show you how. I need the leaves. I'm gonna use them for the mushroom sauce. And the white part, I'm gonna use it for the potatoes. I got here two separate bowls, one for each side, one for the sauce, one for the potato. Just gonna cut them like that. You can use normal onion if you don't have the spring onion, it doesn't really matter. I just use this because I got it in the garden and it's... I like it as well. And we got one spring garlic. I'm gonna cut the leaves again. I'm gonna cut them for the mushroom sauce. And this, the bulb, I'm gonna cut it like this in half. Finally chop it. And we're gonna use it for the potato. The mushrooms, I'm gonna keep them like this. I'm not gonna cut them, I'm gonna leave them whole and you will see why. So this is all the prep what we need to do. Now we're gonna start to cook. I forgot again to mention that I'm gonna need some oil. I'm gonna use 50 milliliters of vegetable oils. I'm gonna put it in a pot and I'm gonna start with the potato. I think the oil is hot enough. So we're gonna put the onion and the garlic in. Got it here. Finely chopped. You don't need to cook it for too long because the spring onion and the garlic, it will cook extremely fast. Remember what I said on the previous videos? You need to put some salt. Always on the onion. I'm gonna put a little bit more salt because the potato needs a lot of salt. Mix it well. And I'm gonna put some black pepper as well. If you wanna do it spicy, just add some cayenne pepper and will be definitely spicy. The onion and the garlic are cooked, so So I'm gonna put the paprika in. Mix very well. And straight away you go with the potato in, with the grated potato. Don't cook the paprika too much, otherwise it will be bitter and unedible. Mix it very, very well and put the heat down on minimum. And carry on mixing until it's everything combined nicely. When you see on the bottom of the pan the starch of the potato, it starts sticking, it means your potatoes are ready. I'm gonna put the lid on and I'm gonna put it on the side. Now I'm gonna go with the smoked lard in. I'm not gonna use any butter for this recipe. I'm gonna use the Transylvanian butter, the smoked lard. And I'm gonna leave it to melt nicely on medium to low heat. Our smoked lard is cooked on one side, so we're gonna flip it on the other side. You can see how nice it looks. And we'll leave it another 2-3 minutes on this side on low heat. Now that the smoked lard is cooked and it's nicely melted inside, I'm gonna take it out. You can see how nice it looks. I'm gonna take it out and I'm gonna put it on the side. And we can go with the steak in with this lovely sirloin. I will leave it 2 minutes on each side and after we take it out I will leave it to rest. Before it's cooked on the first side, I'm gonna put half of the garlic and the other half. I give a bit of shake and like that will flavor all the fat and all that flavor will go in the steak, of course. Now it's cooked on one side, so we're gonna flip it on the other one. Look at that, it's amazing. Look at that sear. That looks very nice. I will leave it another 2 minutes on this side and after we take it out and we leave it to rest. Now that the steak is cooked, I'm gonna take off all this garlic and I'm gonna cook the fat. And now we can take it out, we put it on the side and we leave it to rest. Now we're gonna start the mushroom sauce. I put here the fat which I had left from the steak. I put it in here and we go in straight away because that's very hot with the onion and the garlic. Make sure it doesn't burn, otherwise it will taste bitter. I will put some of the salt in. This onion and garlic doesn't have to cook more than a minute, otherwise will turn bitter and it's not very nice flavor. So I leave it for a minute and after we go with the mushroom in. This is a very simple and basic sauce, but because we got the porcini mushrooms, they grow in the forests in Transylvania, they are very common. The spring onion, the garlic, you got it in the garden, everybody have it in the garden, so it's as traditional as possible. Now we're gonna go with the mushrooms in. I keep a little bit of the juice as well. And I'll keep mixing for 2-3 minutes. Make sure you give a good mix so it doesn't burn. And now I'm gonna put some water in. And I'm gonna leave it to simmer on very low heat for another 3 minutes. You can use stock if you want. I'm just gonna put some water because I put some of the mushroom stock as well, the porcini stock, and it's full of flavor. Now what I'm gonna do, I know it can be called a little bit cheating, but I'm gonna put some double cream because I like it. I like the sauce to be very creamy. So I'm gonna put a touch of double cream just to bring all together. And again we leave it to boil for 2 minutes. And my mushroom sauce, it's ready. It's nice and creamy. We'll put it on the side and we're gonna start with the plating. For the plating I'm gonna use a normal flat plate. I will put it on the side for now, because first I need to slice the steak. I like to slice it before we put it on the plate. It's nice and pink. It's a lovely steak. I will put it back on the plate for now. After we saw how the steak looks, we should start to do the plating. I'm gonna use 2 spoons, I'm gonna do canals from the potato. Now we go in with the mushroom sauce.
which is here. And of course, the smoked fried lard. This is how we cook a steak in Transylvania.
And it finally came the taste test moment. I got here my lovely steak. You see the potato as well, the smoked lard, and the steak cooked medium with the mushroom sauce on top. Let's have a bite. I will take some of the potatoes, some mushroom. Divine. You definitely don't need a knife for the steak. It's so tender and juicy. It's amazing. And the Transylvanian octopus. It's definitely a match. I would like to say a huge thank you to everybody who watched all this series of video. The Transylvanian food. I'm very proud and very happy that I show you a part, a tiny part of the Transylvanian dishes. I hope you did enjoy it, and don't forget that from next week we're gonna start with the Mediterranean cuisine. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you on next week with the first dish and the first video from the Mediterranean cuisine. Thank you.